Hi there. Okay, today we're going to talk about two things. First of all, how we can build the strongest and the fastest car in the game. And then second of all, I want to compare Subaru body kits from the stock one to the DTM. Because in yesterday's movie, I mentioned that the DTM kit is better in terms of aerodynamic properties, I think that's the correct word. And it's not entirely like I thought, so I wanna just clarify there a few things. Okay, let's start with the engine, guys. So if you've seen my clip called "How to Build a Fast Car," you'll notice that I encourage you to use this setup, and I perhaps mentioned use the word that this is sort of the fastest. It was the fastest for me. It's not definitely the fastest in the game. There is something else you can do, and I was planning to do it before, but this is a good occasion. So I had a conversation yesterday with a player called No Name 2. Thank you for that, mate, because you sort of initiated it. And I'm used to the fact that people with cars like yours are not really willing to share the information. And I decided to go public so others can go as know about it as well. It took me nearly 3 months to get to possess that information. It's not easily accessible either on Discord or YouTube. So anyway, I hope if you want to build a fast car, this will help you. So the idea is currently I'm running Feather Set setup with 30% of boost, which means that I'm going to have two collection parts boost 50 to the speed. Two gold parts with the boost for collection parts 50 to the speed, and three parts with power 10% stronger. Now, what you can do better than that, obviously, it's to do something like this. The problem that currently, if I'm going to run 40%, you see my speed is dropping drastically. In the practice, that means that I won't be able, if I, for example, want to do a drag race on sand pits, I won't be able to reach speed of 300 kilometers per hour. So this won't work right now. This is, though, the ultimate setup for the game. And there is a little hatch, a little hook in that. I'll tell you in a second. So ultimately, you want to have a feather set with one collection part bonus 50 to the speed and 40% boost to NOS. Now, the reason why my set doesn't work right now, it's if you notice this little thing, the speed stats, okay? As you see, they're pathetic, okay? And that's why this set won't work. The only thing which will work right now is if I have on all those gold cards speed above 50 plus. Okay, so initially when you grind and you build your engine, this is the setup you want to start with. Because if you, for example, if you're naive like I was initially to wait for two green sets, like for example, I was waiting for Feather and Nitro and I was running it with one collection part. It's a killing car, don't get me wrong. The problem is that anything like that will beat you. Okay, so this is the first step out of the green parts and to use just a single set, for example, Feather, depending also the purpose, right? Because if you want to grind, for example, you want to use Frost mainly, I would assume. And you want to build your traction in terms of Feather. So I would say for drifting, Frost with Feather set will be ultimate. Will be an ultimate build, but if you want a drag race, you want to have 40 boost to NOS with on each card, you want to have the speed stats above 50. Okay, then on St. Petersburg, you're going around 50 seconds per run. Okay, that's all below 60 seconds, which until recently I thought that a lot of cheaters does, because if you have 2 or 3 days of gameplay, it's impossible for you to gather those parts, simple as that. So there will be people you will come across with such awesome setups with 2 days of experience in the game, which I would assume that they're cheating, because I couldn't expect that someone would be that stupid to dump such amount of money just to buy those parts, you know, rather than spend a couple of weeks and get them anyway. All right, so that will be it. Let me just check that. Yes, so I got back to my 30%, because this is right now, this car is ultimate speed for me. With the parts and the stats they offer, I cannot do anything better than that. Trust me, I've tried that. And now we're gonna go to comparing the body kits. Okay, I'm gonna use the Detroit glitch to demonstrate, because that's what my main focus is for the last couple of days, maybe not weeks, maybe 2 weeks or so, or three. Anyway, and while I'm also learning how to be a smoother driver with this beast and with my junior car, which is slightly weaker than that, I want to show you on the ultimate speed the difference between in handling in the air between the DTM body kit for Subaru and the stock one. I mean, stock one, obviously the one we can buy, you know, stock, I mean, here. So whatever your upgrades are, we're going to start with this, actually. Also, guys, you might notice that my wheels are sticking out a little bit. This is just to improve the landing abilities. Also, one trick which you can do if you don't mind losing speed is to increase chamber. And my most preferred angle for this, it's if you set it around between the W and H letter, which will give you this angle. But what it ultimately does, except the fact that it takes the traction off, so you're not gonna be as fast as you were, it actually makes the surface of your landing wider. So if you notice the bottom edges, right this place and right this, all that creates a surface which will be wider, and it's much easier to land from the jumps if you're crazy and you don't know how to brake, which we all do initially. But because I like to have a good grip and good connection, I'm going like this. I've spent a couple of days driving with chamber. It's fun, and it's fun cornering if you have, especially if you have feather set. It's really, I like it. But you know, you're gonna lose the speed, so that's the trick. Also, you don't really do anything to the car while having wheels like this, so try. Also, when you drift, try to do a back wheels a little bit like that. See how it goes. I like it personally, but I feel this is the matter of preference. Anyway, all right, I'm going to stop talking right now and just do 10 runs with each set so you guys can see how the car behaves. I'll try as much as I can to be as precise in terms of maneuvering to repeat the jumps as closely in terms of technical presentation. So we can all compare how it looks. I've checked today, and in the air there isn't much of a difference, but the DTM set, it's much more grounded, so all the tricks when you hit the ground are much more under control, and the probability that it will land back on wheels, it's much greater. If you land on the side on the roof, if you add nose, it's much greater to land on wheels than with the standard one, regardless from the wheel setup. So anyway, I hope that helps. Please let me know in comments your opinion, if you have any. Yes, if you like it, you know what to do. If you don't like it, we don't need to know about it. Have a great new year, guys. Enjoy that clip, and I'll see you next time. Bye-bye.
All right. Thank you.